This wet weather may inspire you to do some yard work. Here's the Weekend Gardener with some tips for you this morning.
Hello, gardening friends. Welcome to the Weekend Gardener. We've had a lot of flea beetles this year in the fall. Not real common, but because fall has been so warm and so long and a few dips in the cool weather, and so the plants get stressed. And the flea beetles are one of the ones that make these kind of holes and this damage on the leaf. Cosmetically, it looks bad, and who wants to eat something that looks like that anyway? So it's a tough insect to control. It's a flea beetle, so every time you go up there, it jumps off the plant. Very difficult to control. And who wants to treat the soil for something that you may not have any good results with? So I would encourage you to use white paper. It's very important to use white instead of yellow like other traps. And what you'll do is get a wire or a coat hanger to put this on. And then this is a product called Tanglefoot. Tanglefoot has been around a very long time. If you've ever used it, you know how sticky it is. It will not come off of your finger for hours or days, really. It's very hard to get it off of there. And so use something like a little popsicle stick like we've got right here today. And then look at that. And so we will smear this all over the white paper. And let me show you down here now the results of that. Being so difficult to control, this is very successful. A flea beetle jumped on that one already. Look at that. These are the flea beetles that most people are having a very hard time of getting control of. So we stick these in there around the garden. We have several places where we will put this in there. And look at that. So if you space these throughout the garden, the flea beetles are attracted to the white. The tanglefoot will hold them. We use the tanglefoot because if you use Vaseline or hair wax, anything like that, it'll just run off in the heat. So there you go. There's another suggestion for your organic garden, and it's very effective and one of those alternatives to using any other kind of pesticide. For the Weekend Gardener, I'm John Dromgoole. I'll see you next week.
And for more information, you can catch John's gardening show on KLBJ 590 AM.